Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. On the SGI graph, you see earthquakes with magnitude 5.5 and larger. We see some clusters, and I'm going to explain this. On the 27th, we had a clustering, three strong earthquakes in the higher five magnitude range. And that was at the time of new moon and also the convergence of semi-right angle lunar geometry with Jupiter and Saturn. And that was a significant convergence there because 2 days later we had two magnitude 6 earthquakes on the 29th, and there was 6.2 off the west coast of South Island, New Zealand, and also further south, 6.8 at Macquarie Island region. Significant strong seismic activity. And then on the 2nd, I mentioned the planetary conjunction with Earth, Venus, and Neptune. It was a near convergence with a lunar geometry with Jupiter on the 30th. That's the high green peak. And right at the time of that planetary conjunction, we had a major earthquake magnitude 7.4 at the Drake Passage. That is at the south tip of South America, Chile. It was followed by a magnitude 6 earthquake a day later on the 3rd at Minahasa, Sulawesi, Indonesia. And that's another cluster of stronger seismic activity, even major seismic activity. We see on the 4th, that's today, some lunar geometry. That's a lunar conjunction with Mars and the high peaks there. That is lunar geometry with Jupiter and Saturn. That brings us to the next time frame. You see right here, Mars last night, a lunar conjunction and a near convergence with lunar geometry, semi-right angle geometry with Jupiter and Saturn. It is not really in sync there. Mars is a little bit to the left, so it may not be all that strong. We're probably going to see some seismic increase later today. Tomorrow, higher 5, maybe a magnitude 6, I'm not sure. Then we see many red and purple labels, and that's because from the 7th to the 10th, we have a convergence of all kinds of semi-right angle geometry with Mercury and Venus combined. And they make geometry from the 7th to the 10th with Jupiter, Saturn, and Neptune. That's quite a convergence there. We're probably going to see seismic increase overall in those days. There's a huge lunar peak right there. That's because of the lunar geometry of Saturn, Neptune, and Venus. I'm going to highlight the most significant planetary geometry there as well. And that is on the 9th. That is Mercury, Venus, Neptune, semi-right angle geometry, followed by Venus, Mercury, Neptune later on the same day. They usually come in pairs, and that's because Mercury and Venus are close to the Sun relative to the outer planets. And then it's going to be followed by Sun, Mercury, Uranus at a right angle, and most importantly, Venus, Jupiter, Saturn at a right angle. The last time that Venus, Jupiter, Saturn was in a right angle, that was in March. It was followed by a 7.6 magnitude earthquake. It was a convergence with Mercury. If that's going to happen again, that's the question, but it is quite a convergence here on the 9th and 10th of geometry involving Mercury and Venus and outer planets. So I'd say around the 10th, give or take one day, there could be the largest seismic response to that geometry. Then we have a full moon later on the 12th, converging with a lunar conjunction with Uranus. And that means that Earth, Sun, and Uranus are almost in a conjunction. That's going to be in the following time frame. If we consider this convergence there of on the 12th, 13th, I'd say around the 14th, there could be an obvious seismic response to that geometry. I'm going to show some atmospheric anomalies because we had strong fluctuations yesterday, even 4 millivolts, which is quite strong. And I marked regions Alaska in the north, and then over Tonga, Fiji, and New Zealand. We had strong seismic activity at South Island, New Zealand, 6.2, and further south of Macquarie Islands. Also some increased activity at the Kermadec Islands recently, and New Zealand is right in the middle. There could be stronger seismic activity coming up in the short term due to a stressed redistribution north and south of New Zealand. That is something to keep in mind. But Alaska, it's also been a while since Alaska had stronger seismic activity. So that's also something to keep in mind. On the other side of the globe, I marked a line over Africa, and that also deserves some attention, south of Iceland on the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, but more importantly, North Africa, Algeria. We picked up some anomalies last month, and now again, quite strong. And if you look at history, there has been a magnitude 7.3 earthquake many years ago in Algeria along that fault in North Africa. So the fault is active. Sometimes we see some increased seismic activity there, but the last month we picked up some anomalies, and now again pretty strong one. If there's going to be a major earthquake and at what spot exactly, we don't know, but this is an important indicator. And then finally, also South America, 3.5 millivolts also yesterday, and we had this magnitude 7.4 at the Drake Passage, and it was the south end of Chile, South America. And if you look at recent years, most of the magnitude 7 earthquakes occurred to the north. That's northern Chile last year, but especially Peru and Ecuador. Chile itself has not had major or very large seismic activity. The last time a magnitude 8 occurred was in 2015. That's 10 years ago. And here we see near Arica, that's the bend. This is the notorious bend where magnitude 9 earthquakes can occur. And the last time that happened was in 1868. We haven't seen really large seismic activity in the last 10 years since that magnitude 8 in 2015. So we could see increased seismic activity in the short term in Chile as well. And that has a lot to do with the stress redistribution, especially now with this 7.4 at the Drake Passage. Finally, the Marmara Sea, we had the magnitude 6 earthquake in the middle of the Marmara Sea, of course, and there was a lot of aftershock activity, magnitude 5, but mostly magnitude 4 and magnitude 3. There is still some aftershock activity, but only in the magnitude 3 range right now, so it seems to be decreasing. However, we do see some stress redistribution signs with a magnitude 3 earthquake 2 days ago, again, on the fault that is considered locked by many scientists since the 1766. There's a lot of discussion which fault was which fault broke in the last 100 years since 1894. Exact epicenters are unknown, but it is estimated that, for example, the magnitude 7 or 6.9, around magnitude 7 in 1894 occurred furthest to the south and not to the north, where the fault erupted last in 1766. So there is some uncertainty, but the fault is locked, and we do see some signs of stress redistribution there. It doesn't mean that it's going to be a major earthquake in the short term, but we can't rule out the possibility either. This is the update for now. Check out the website and also the latest updates in our social media. Our website was inaccessible because of many visits, especially from Turkey. So many people tried to get the information on our website, and our server just couldn't handle it. So I think it's now okay. You can access the website again without any problems. This is the update. Stay safe. Until next time.